A group of young voters just got together at the Reagan Ranch in California to share ideas on the steps they think need to be taken to strengthen the conservative movement in America. Joining me now are two of those college students that attended the Young America's Foundation Conference, Vinciane Ngonsi from Truman State University and John Eick from the University of North Carolina. Good morning, guys.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Okay, John, let me start with you. You're meeting at the Reagan Ranch, of course, to talk about the next steps for the conservative movement. What are those?
Well, I think the next step for the conservative movement is to reach out to the younger generation, those that are currently in college as we speak. Let me tell you, the national debt is currently approaching $14 trillion, and the Congress is going to have to decide in the coming weeks whether or not to increase the debt ceiling to $14.3 trillion. And, you know, that figure is roughly equivalent to the entire economy of the United States in terms of GDP. And so, you know, that is an unsustainable amount of spending. And I think we need not look any further than the current situation in Greece to realize the disastrous effects that such uncontrollable spending can have on a national economy.
Vinciane, I want to bring you in because you two are obviously very engaged in the political process, as are all the young people with you this weekend. But, you know, only 21% of your age group, the 18 to 29-year-olds, voted in the midterms. Why?
You know, that everyone asks me that question all the time, and it's very puzzling. I think, you know, they lost the momentum, and that's unfortunate. You know, everyone had such a momentum in 2008, and a lot of people, a lot of young people saw how much the federal government wasn't doing a good job, so I don't think they really felt as encouraged to go out and vote as they may have felt 2 years ago in 2008.
John, what do the folks there at your weekend think about the Tea Party?
I honestly think that the opinion about the Tea Party is mixed. I think some people certainly appreciate the amount of enthusiasm that it brought to the conservative movement. Gave us great candidates in Florida with Marco Rubio winning the Senate race over there, Rand Paul winning in Kentucky. Yet at the same time, a lot of conservative activists think that we left some races on the table, specifically in Delaware, where Christine O'Donnell got trounced by Chris Coons, where maybe Mike Castle would have been a more appropriate candidate, or even in Nevada, where Sharon Angle lost to Harry Reid.
Sure. Well,
I think opinion is mixed.
It's interesting stuff that you all are doing out there. Keep us posted on your findings after the weekend. John Eick and Vinciane Ngonsi, thanks so much for coming on.
Thank you so much for having us.
Thanks for having us. Thank you.